subscribe, like, do what you want, really. Mr. Shaw here, and thanking you so very kindly for the reactions to the first two videos. So positive, so much love. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And posting this by way of update. Video one told the story of this composite winged eagle, big eagle on the left. Video number two told the story of this United States Championship on the right. Both from eBay seller Infinity Belts. Two very, very different experiences. This had a number of flaws, took those to the seller. They weren't interested in doing very much other than promising better things next time. So I gave them a chance and we went next time. They did give me a whole £5 off this belt on the right. And then we were moving towards belt number three, the mix of the Reggie Parks WCW world title and the big gold. You know I'm not a fan of the big gold, but I thought, can we jazz it up? Can we make it better? Well, I went to Infinity Belt, said, can you make the belt? They're like, yes, but we want you to change the feedback for this one. I said, well, you haven't really done anything for me. And it's not fair for me to say, oh yes, this was fantastic, when it wasn't. That's not fair on anybody who might be buying from them in the future. So things have gone quiet. Best part of a week's gone by. I've messaged every other day just saying, oh, can I see the artwork for belt number three, etc. Nothing. And then I've noticed that their eBay store is now empty. No listed items. Now, it might be because they're going to do new photography for new products, you know, better close-ups, wherever it might well be. It might be they've decided to shut up shop and quit. Or it might be that perhaps they're going to rebrand and relaunch. We'll keep an eye on eBay to see whether that is the case. Now, just before I launch into what we're going to do about belt number three, just a couple of things, or rather one thing about this belt on the right that I didn't notice during the unbagging, because of course, very, very excited. You kind of see everything, but not everything at the same time. Just notice, if you look at the tooling on the top of the belt here, you see that tooling there and how snug this plate is to that tooling as it goes down. It's pretty much touching those patterns running down the side of the leather. But not the case here on the right. You can see actually the tooling and the plate are separate. And that again is because this front plate is over-rotated and should be a couple of degrees round to the left or anti-clockwise. It's all right, I'm living with it, but having walked past it for a few weeks now, I've just started to notice that. A minor niggle, but otherwise I'm very, very happy with it. So, radio silence, this shop no longer exists. We'll see if they come back in a new way. Maybe there will be a part three to what I'm now calling the Infinity Saga. No, not that one, probably get sued. But does that mean the dream is over then for the blend of the Reggie Parks and the Big Gold? Well, no, it doesn't, because I have been talking to another seller, and that other seller is going to make this for me. So I'm going to save up, I'm going to have it made, but in the meantime, I thought I'll show you the sketches so you know what we're working towards. So sketch number one was very much like this. It's a Big Gold with NWA Junior Heavyweight plates on the side and bluey blacky leather, and you can see the NWA rings between the plates on the sides as well. But I thought, you know what, that's a bit boring. Can we do better? I have a great love of the WBC Boxing Championship. So then I went with this. I thought, big gold front plate, NWA junior side plates, NWA rings, and then this kind of graded approach on the green. Of course, the WCW belts go straight out with the arms, whereas this is grading in, getting smaller towards the outside. But then, nah, can we do better? And then I thought, can we stick a globe on it and it look all right? So then I thought, big gold front plate, stick a Reggie Parks globe on it, and then put the original WCW Reggie Parks side plates on. Not really sold on that either. Then I came up with the final design, and this is the one that hopefully it's going to look like in a month or so when I get my hands on it. Probably the best drawing of the lot. There you go. We're going to take the Reggie Parks fan from the top and the World Heavyweight and the WCW. We're going to remain with the wrestling champion of the Big Gold. We're going to add the stars down either side. We're going to add the Reggie Parks globe and the little fan at the bottom here from the WCW Heavyweight. We're then going to add NWA side plates. These might have to be the world title ones with the one flags, because I'm not sure the seller does the junior heavyweight weight ones. We're then going to stick in the NWA rings between them, and then put it all on a nice blue leather. I think that's a nice thing. Certainly better than Seth Rollins's toy come clock of a championship that he's currently walking around with now. So hold with me, stay with me, and we'll see what that looks like in a few weeks. But what until then? Well, I thought, I absolutely love real wrestling belts, as in real full scale ones, but I also love action figure wrestling belts. So the next few weeks, I'm going to be doing videos that are going to select the 8 best action figure belts ever made. And then we're going to have a tournament to find out what is the best. So keep an eye out for that video. And indeed, keep an eye out for the eventual arrival of this Reggie Parks Come Big Gold Beauty. It's going to be opened right here on this table in a few weeks' time. Until then, so long. Take care, everybody.